Hello and welcome back. We'll talk about like various regions, why most of the data lake fails. So where we'll toss up on different attributes, different criteria, like what exactly the region. Then we'll definitely wrap up with some of the what are the actual strategies we should really follow to make a successful data lake.
For more in depth concept, I would recommend please visit my other video, which really talks about the data lake concept and what exactly it's used for, all those things. So that will be that will give you a better idea about the data lake and how you really start up.
Unfortunately, many of these on-premise data lake projects fail to fulfill the promise of data lake computing and high complexity and slow time to value, definitely. And the other most important thing is like poor governance, right? So those are the inherent complexities of a distributed architecture, and the need for custom coding for data transformation and integration mainly handled by highly skilled data engineers. In fact, some estimates place the failure rate for Hadoop data lake projects as high as 70%, right? So although many Hadoop based data lake projects are not delivering their promised value, organizations of all types still want all the insights from all their data by all their users, right? The most important regions of the failure, the first is like skill gaps, right? So the skills needed to really build or maintain a data warehouse are not the same skill needed to build a data lake, right? So a data lake project will require someone with experience in big data engineering, as well as a team with a capability for coding, building, and managing the data lake throughout the implementation process. So otherwise, you risk risk overwhelming your IT and developer team and creating a data lake that never is its fulfilled potential, right? Another reason behind this, most of the failure is undefined goals, right? So the data lake is created, raw data is dumped, and no plan is established for how the data will be used or how insights will be will be extracted from that data lake itself. So without a clear course of action and strong partnerships between IT and business team, the data lake will never live up to its full potential, right? The third one would be like the data architecture, right? The legacy trap makes it difficult to create a data architecture that processes agility and portability. Every day we are getting new tools, technology, which really deals with all these problems. So without flexibility and adaptability, definitely data lakes can miss out on new services, right? As a result, implementing changes may result in unnecessary transition costs. Maybe a year or two, the data lake is working fine, but what when there are massive amount of data ingesting into the data lake, and the data lake is not performing in the right way, so that there is a scalability issue come on the way. One of reason of the failure is the data quality. The size of global data sphere is projected to reach maybe somewhere around 160 or 170 zettabyte by the year of 2025, right? So that's roughly the equivalent of watching the entire Netflix catalog 90 million times or maybe 1 million times, I would say. So with so much data, with so much data being produced, processed and stored, opportunities for errors are everywhere, right? So error can occur anywhere. So in legacy, in legacy draft situations, so the tools needed to clean, profile and process data may lag behind the data itself. So all those dirty data can generate enormous waste in terms of both time and money, as well as companies struggle to solve data quality issues, right? So if we are pushing unwanted data, very, you know, dirty data, and whatever we want, we are just trying to push that into the data lake, then in future, in under the hood, it will really take long time to clean up the data. So now, ultimately, it's just adding more time, processing time to your downstream application as well. So all in all, the performance is going down. So that's why the data quality is really important. One other, reason is security and compliance, right? So when we are talking about security and compliance, so definitely a data lake is a great option for warehousing data from many different sources, but securing it can be a challenge, right? So when we are talking about GDPR system, right? So GDPR and other regulatory compliance standards means that liability is on the line, and it comes with its own risk, right? And financial penalties, and it also damages the reputation of the organization, right? So the legacy trap creates security and compliance vulnerability because of the hinder implementation of the most current data security protocols, right? So anytime we are trying to push the data into the data lake, we have to really think of all these kind of, you know, regulatory system and the compliance and all these security related stuff need to be really keep in back of your mind when you are really building the data pipeline. Then only it will be considered as a very good data pipeline, or maybe the success rate would be higher. It's very, very difficult to, you know, apply the security and compliance as well. So that's why you have to think in alternate way, like in what way we can really apply this security and compliance on top of the data lake you are designing. So these are the reasons which are really contributing to failure of any data lake. Okay, and data lake projects. So in summary, if you talk about like why exactly the most data lakes fail, first thing is the slow performance. What does that mean? It's slow queries, right? When we are querying any data from that, then we have to really fast clean the data and structure the data, and then we can really get some meaningful data, right? And unnecessary data read. As we said, like to really get the right data to read, we have to really go through lots of data set before that. Right, so which is unnecessary reads and adds that performance degradation to the application itself, right? And the other thing is delays through the data team, right? In the sense like, okay, whenever you are request some of the data from a data lake, then if you request to the data team, so data team will think of like, okay, how can we really cross the data and we can really send the data back to the requester, right? And the other thing is definitely the high complexity, right? So think about like, okay, you have ingested some data from some of the IoT, right? And maybe some sensor data. Okay, so in that case, once you have already ingested the data, but sometime if you are really you're making the clock back and you want to re-ingest the data, you have already ingested for some of the hours, and you are again trying to trying to ingest same interval data set again. So what it will do, it will get another copy of that particular data we have already ingested earlier, right? So hard to manage, definitely, and we are keep ingesting the data, and to for the management of that whole data set is really, really difficult, right? And of course, to really hold on this whole infrastructure or the platform, is you need a very very good skill, professional to deal with those kind of high complexity problems. The third one is the poor governance. The poor governance is nothing but the inadequate resource and access control. So definitely, when we ingest the data, as we talk about in the previous slide, so the security and compliances, right? So we don't have that adequate amount of security in place. So because of that, so anyone can really able to access the any kind of personal data from the data lake itself. Correct. So there is no much hard and fast access control applied to the on top of the data lake, right? And there are many kind of formats and poor integration, definitely. So when there are many kind of formats, so there is no single way where you can really tunnel your data to the destination, right? So that's one of the problem. Adds to the failure. And then definitely is no audit trails, right? Audit trails, okay, we are keep ingesting the data and we don't have any history of the data, reason why you have ingested that, okay? And what are the, did we ingested any PII kind of information data set, like okay, any personal information is available in those data sets, and if that is the case, should we really clean up those data in a regular interval? All those things, it's not there, right? No audit trail in place. So these are the three most important cause of the most of the data lake failures, right? So think of then if all these things are happens, then how there are lots of data lakes are really great successful, how big organizations they are really dealing with their their petabytes of terabytes of data. So yeah, definitely that will be another topic altogether, and we'll talk about that in a different session, which will talk about like what are the different best strategies for modernizing a data lake, and what is the great way of dealing with the data lake problems and make it super successful. Right. Thank you so much for visiting the channel, and please share and subscribe the channel. Bye and take care for now. See you then.